The winter evening settles down with smells of steaks in passageways. 6 o'clock, the burnt out ends of smoky days. Shower wraps the grimy scraps of withered leaves about your feet, and newspapers from vacant lots. The showers beat on broken blinds and chimney pots, and at the corner of the street, alone. Steams and stamps, and then the lighting of the lamps. The morning comes to consciousness, the faint stale smells of beer from the sawdust trampled streets, with all its muddy feet that press twirly coffee stands. With all the other masquerades, the time resumes. One thinks of all the hands that are raising into shapes and 1,000 furnished rooms. You tossed a blanket up from the bed you lay upon your back, and waited, you dozed and watched the nights revealing the thousand sordid images of which your soul was constituted. They flickered across the ceiling, and when all the world came back and the lights crept up between the shutters, and you heard the sparrows in the gutters, and you had such a vision of the street as the street only understands, sitting along the bed's edge where you curled the papers up from your hair, or clasped the yellow soles of feet in the palms of both soiled hands. His soul stretched height across the skies that fade behind a city block, more trampled by insistent feet at 4 and 5 and 6 o'clock, and the short square fingers stuffing pipes and evening newspapers and eyes. Short of certainties, the conscience of a blackened street. Impatient to assume the world, oh, I am moved by fancies that are curled around these images and cling the notion of some infinitely gentle, infinitely suffering thing. Wipe your hands across your mouth and laugh. The worlds revolve like ancient whips.